Hi, my name is Karen Strawn, and I'm the Youth Program Coordinator at the Dixon Gallery and Gardens. The Dixon is an art museum surrounded by 17 acres of beautiful gardens with a little something for everyone. We have rainbows, and we have woods. We have races, and we have walks. There's so much to discover at the Dixon, and today I wanted to focus on the science side. We're going to take a closer look at a newer addition to the Dixon Gallery and Gardens, the Reynolds Family Greenhouse. The Reynolds Family Greenhouse opened in the spring of 2019 with the Farnsworth Education Building and the surrounding education gardens. Think of it like an indoor garden and also an outdoor classroom. We can grow plants for different programs, but we can also use it as a space for workshops and various field trips and to get our hands dirty. Also, notice how the whole building is made of windows? That's going to come in handy later.
It's a pretty cool building, right? But you still might be wondering, okay, what is a greenhouse and why exactly do you use it? To answer that, we need to take a little bit of a closer look at what's growing inside of it. Let's say we want to grow a tomato. What do we need? You got it. Sunlight, water, nutrients, room to grow, air, and what does a tomato grow from? A seed. So we start with a seed. We add sunlight, water, nutrients, air, room to grow, and some time. The seed grows and germinates and produces a little sprout. Add sunlight, water, nutrients, air, room to grow, and time. That sprout grows into a seedling. Add sunlight, water. Okay, you got it. And the seedling grows into a young plant, then an adult plant, then produces a flower. In the case of fruits and vegetables, the flower produces the food, the fruit, the vegetable.
Okay, remember our greenhouse? Why do we use it? We just talked about what a plant needs to grow and came up with a pretty good list, but there's one thing we didn't cover. Temperature. We can provide water, we can provide nutrients and air and space and even access to sunlight. But unfortunately, we can't wrap seeds in teeny tiny little sweaters when the soil outside is cold. And that's where greenhouses help. Remember all those windows? They capture the sun's heat and keep plants nice and warm even when it's cold outside. Greenhouses let the sunlight in, but they also keep the wind and hungry animals out.
Now that we've learned a little bit about greenhouses and how plants grow and how greenhouses can help plants grow, I want to share with you how to make your very own miniature greenhouse indoors.
Before starting your greenhouse, you want to think about what you want to plant in it. This is a great opportunity to use foods that you already have, like apples. The seeds are right there in the middle, plus a tasty snack. Zucchini seeds are nice and big and easy to get out of the center. And then an extra fun one of my favorites, sugar snap peas. Super crunchy and easy to split down the middle, open them up, and all of the seeds are right there in that little pod. Pull them out and you can use them for this activity. We're also going to need a few other materials, including cotton balls, spray bottle with water, some tape, and some mark making materials that can be crayons or markers, colored pencils, whatever you have. Then we're going to need some scissors, a sheet of paper, and a Ziploc bag. The Ziploc bag is going to be the inside of your greenhouse and the paper will create the frame, and that's where we'll start right now. To make the outside of the greenhouse, I like to use that plastic bag as a template. Just place it on my paper over to the side. We're going to draw a line just slightly larger than the bag and then cut down that line. Now we're going to use this scrap for another part of the greenhouse so you can set it to the side. And then we want to make a window for the bag. So I'm just going to make a mark just inside the Ziploc bag. Move it to the side and make a mark here. And then on the other side. And then we're going to cut out that window. The easiest way is to fold it in half, connect the two lines with a rectangle and then cut those out, very similar to folding paper to make a snowflake. When we're done cutting it out, we can open it back up. Here's our window, fits right on the bag, and there's the base for the greenhouse. Now we want to make a rooftop. So we'll get that scrap piece of paper, and you can turn that rectangle into a triangle with those two lines right there, and then we'll cut that one out as well. Before assembling our greenhouses, we're going to decorate them. So grab your crayons, your pencils, your markers, whatever you have on hand, and try playing with different patterns, using different colors. Mix it up. Then move to the outside of your greenhouse. Living things can also grow in the front. Once you've finished coloring, it's time to assemble your greenhouse. You'll need your Ziploc bag, the frame of your greenhouse, and also the rooftop, and you'll want to go ahead and grab that tape or glue stick. First, put the roof and the framework of your greenhouse, the body with the window together, tape those, and then put the Ziploc bag on the back of your paper, and we're going to open the bag and tape three sides down. We want the top to be open so that we can put the seeds inside. Now that we've finished building the greenhouse, it's time to plant our seeds. For that, we'll need our cotton balls. Go ahead and get those seeds back in front of you, whatever you've selected and have around. We'll also need the spray bottle with water. And to start, I spray one of the balls with water. We want it to be damp, but not dripping wet. Get a seed, put it in the middle, give it a little hug, and then set it aside. Grab another cotton ball. Spray it with water, again damp, not too wet, but not too dry. Put a seed in the middle and wrap it up in a tight hug. And then finish that process with the rest of your seeds. Now that you have all the seeds assembled, it's time to put them in the greenhouse. So open your Ziploc bag right up there at the top. Place each little cotton ball with the seed at the bottom. And you want to spread them out across the bottom so that they have some room to sprout. 4, one more 5. And once they're all tucked at the bottom, we're going to close that Ziploc bag, hang your greenhouse in a sunny window, and watch them grow.
I hope you've enjoyed planting with us, and we would love to see your greenhouses, so please, share the images on Facebook and Instagram, tag the Dixon, or hashtag Discover the Dixon. Happy growing.